right, guys. Well, I'm back today with a really cool 22 long rifle handgun, the Beretta Model 70. If you follow the channel, you know I've been doing a lot with mouse guns, tip-up barrel Berettas, and 22 long rifles lately, and this one checks off all of those boxes. It's a cool piece of history that is a smooth shooting handgun. And honestly, up until a few months ago, I didn't know this existed until a lot of companies started importing the Beretta Model 71, and I actually got to hold one down at Beltway Gun and Pond in Matthews, North Carolina. Also, guys, if you swing by Beltway Gun and Pond, tell them 704 Tactical sent you over, and you'll get 10% off. In their shop, they had the Model 71, which is pretty much this exact handgun, but with a welded fake suppressor on the end for import restrictions. It wasn't until I started doing some research on the handgun to see if you could remove that fake suppressor easily, I discovered the Model 70 existed, which again is that same handgun, but with no threads on the barrel and no fake suppressor. This is such a cool looking handgun, I had to give it a try, but the pricing on these were a little bit more elevated than the fake suppressor version because they are a little bit more desirable in my opinion. So when guns.com did that huge sale, I snagged this thing for a very good price, and I'm very pleasantly surprised at the quality of this pistol, especially at the price I paid. Let's talk about the basic overview, specs and features, and more importantly, how fun it is to shoot down at the range. The handgun itself is single action only, and the mag release is really interesting, and that's the first thing I want to talk about. It's located on the bottom of the handgun, and the magazines are fairly simple to load, except for I found that sometimes the rounds want to slip out of the back of the magazine. But again, this is an older style handgun, and a lot of those little things can be overlooked. It's a single action only handgun, and the slide release is rather interesting as well. It's located right here, and the hammer stays back. There is no decocker, but you do have a safety that's really easy to engage and simply flip off, and the trigger has a smooth take up and a reasonably crisp break. You can see the sights themselves are adjustable, and somebody went ahead and painted the front sight post green, but you can easily kind of pick up those front sights, and they're more of a target style sight. That's what was really unique about this Model 70 was the fact that it had this really ergonomic grip, a very interesting grip angle, more of a target pistol and target sights. Yet it was a rather small handgun. So as I was shooting it down at the range, I truly found out this really is a micro target 22, and I fell in love with it instantly. It's one of the smoothest shooting 22s I've ever felt in its size, and it was incredibly accurate. Plus, this was very reliable. Let's talk about the ammunition I used when I was running this gun down at the range. I get a lot of questions about the range I shoot at, and I was shooting at Holly Springs Tactical Gun Range located in Mooresboro, North Carolina. Again, if you look those guys up, tell them 704 Tactical sent you over and you will save on range fees. And because of that range, they've got a lot of dynamic shooting situations with a lot of random steel set up everywhere on the range. So it was just fun to try this in all different scenarios. I got to shoot this thing for groups, and it was a tack driver, especially with the ergonomic feel, and I could absolutely rattle off shots as fast as I could pull the trigger, hitting tight fist-sized groups at 5 and 7 yards because this is an all-steel frame gun. There was literally no recoil. This fed everything I put through it, including Winchester, Federal, and Remington bulk pack ammunition, and it was a tack driver with all of the ammo. No problems with hollow points or copper wash jackets. This thing worked great, and I absolutely love it. One of the coolest little handguns I've seen in a while. I do like the fact that a lot of the controls are very ergonomic, despite being rather unique for this pistol, and I do like the little grip at the end of the magazine that helps keep your hand in the proper placement. And again, overall, this is one of the fastest, smoothest, and tack-driving little 22s that I've ever shot. Now, when you get into larger 22s and target 22s, you expect them to function like that. But when you see something small like this, it kind of takes you by surprise, and it is a very nice surprise. So in summary, guys, if you get a chance to buy the Beretta M70 or the M71, like I talked about Beltway having, if you can remove that fake heavy suppressor on the end of the M71, I think you're going to have a really cool pistol. And if you get a chance to grab the M70 where you don't have to fool with that, I think you're going to be pleasantly surprised at the quality, craftsmanship, and performance of this little handgun. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a good one.